Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I'll explain how easy it is to add the Syncfusion Blazor Bullet Chart component to a Blazor Web Assembly application. I will also show you how to configure a few of its basic features like binding data, adding title, subtitle, value bar, target bar, dimensions, and tooltip. Let me start with the application creation process. A Blazor application can be created using Visual Studio 2019 or 2022, Visual Studio Code, or JetBrains Writer. In this video, I'll show you how to create a Blazor WebAssembly application using Visual Studio 2022. Make sure that you have installed compatible SDK versions like the .NET Core SDK 3.1.8, .NET 5.0 SDK, or .NET Core 6.0 SDK. I open Visual Studio 2022 and choose Create a New Project from the dashboard. Then, I choose the Blazor WebAssembly app and click the Next button. I name my project, click Next. Then, I select .NET Core 6.0 as the target framework and click the Create button. The project has been created and is ready to use. Now, I will show you the step-by-step process for adding the bullet chart component to this project. First, I need to install the syncfusion.blazor.bulletchart package to work with the bullet chart component. To do that, I'll open the NuGet package manager, search for the package, and install it in my application. Once installed, you can see the package added to this application's packages folder. Then, I navigate to the _imports.razor page and import the syncfusion.blazor.charts namespace. Next, I navigate to the index.html page within the root folder to add a Syncfusion Bootstrap 5 reference from the installed package. Then, I need to register the Syncfusion Blazor services. In the program.cs file, I import the syncfusion.blazor namespace and register the Syncfusion Blazor service using the @syncfusionblazor method. I also need to register the license using the syncfusion.licensing.syncfusionlicenseprovider.registerlicense method to avoid the license validation message. If you want to know more about the Blazor WebAssembly app and how to add Syncfusion components to it, you can check out the video linked in the card above. The configuration steps are done, so let's move on to adding the Blazor bullet chart component. I will open the index.razor page and add the SF bullet chart tag. Now, to visualize the basic look of the bullet chart component in the browser page, I need to bind a value and target. Inside the @code function, I declare the model class chart data with the fields, field value and target value of type double. Then I declare the public list variable bullet chart data based on the model class chart data and create a list with a field value of 270 and a target value of 250. I assign this list variable to the datasource property of the bullet chart. Then add the value field property to show a value bar and assign the field value field to it. I add the target field property to show the target bar and assign the field target value to it. To specify the minimum range of the scale, I set the minimum property value to 0. And to specify the maximum range of the scale, set the maximum property value to 300. And to specify the range interval for a scale, set interval property value to 50. Let me run this example. See in the output, the bullet chart component is rendered with a minimum range of 0 to maximum of 300. And the interval of scale is 50. The scale has a field value of 270 and a target value of 250. Next, I will show you how to add a title and subtitle to the bullet chart. I add the title property, set its value to revenue, and add the subtitle property, set its value to $1. Looking at the output, the bullet chart is rendered with title and subtitle. Next, I will show you how to add range using the ranges property. I add the bullet chart range collection property to specify the ranges. Inside that, I add the bullet chart range property with 150 as the end property value. In the same way, I add other ranges. The ending point of the quantitative range is specified using the end property. Here, the minimum value is considered the starting point of the first range, and the previous range endpoint is considered the starting point for other ranges. Then, I add the color property in the first chart range with the value red to change the default color. Also change the color of last chart range to blue. See in the output, the bullet chart renders with three ranges and has custom color on range 1 and 3. These ranges display the qualities of good, bad, and satisfactory on the bullet chart scale. Next, I will show you how to customize dimensions to a bullet chart. It can be done by adding a container to the bullet chart and specify the styles inline or through CSS. I customize the dimensions by setting the width to 650 pixels and the height to 100 pixels. See in the output, the bullet chart renders with the specified dimensions. To change the size of the bullet chart, you can use the built-in height and width properties. Finally, I will show how to enable tooltip to a bullet chart. I add the bullet chart tooltip property and set the enable property value to true. Add the type parameter as chart data using tValue property. Remove the height and width property in bullet chart for clear demonstration. See in the output, the tooltip is enabled in the bullet chart. In this video, I have shown you how to create a Blazor WebAssembly application, add a bullet chart component to it, and then configure a few of its basic features. You can download the working example from this video in the GitHub link in the description below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.